Today, we're going to be talking about knowledge bases and AI. Effectively, the ability for you to take your personal notes, your personal information, give that to an AI in a way that an AI can use that to assist you. Ask questions of the notes that you've taken in the past, help you organize those notes in novel and kind of interesting ways, and the ability for you to just help kind of be organized. So I'm a big user of Obsidian, and so that's what we're going to be using today. You could use a lot of different note-taking systems, but I think Obsidian's great largely because it relies on files over using an application. This idea is sort of encapsulated in this post by the CEO of Obsidian, Steph Engo. It's effectively this idea that when you have an application that contains all the data that you really care about, you rely on that application for your interface and your access to that data. But the nice thing about a tool like Obsidian is it saves everything as raw files. And so you're able to just access those files and do whatever you want with them. If you want to shift platforms or change what tool you're using, even away from Obsidian, you have that kind of fine-grained control of being able to use that tool. So I guess first I'm going to do a quick like intro to Obsidian and kind of talk about like why Obsidian is the cool tool that I think it is. So there's a lot of really great features of Obsidian, and we're going to talk about a bunch of them. The first one's really links. So I could link to all the AI posts that we've made on Stable Discussion. That's something really cool. I could also potentially do tags. So ChatGPT might be a tag that we're going to use pretty frequently here, right? So I can click through this. I can kind of see more details from this note, which is basically a collection of all these other notes that we've been taking here on Stable Discussion. I can click through to one of these, and then you can kind of see details about this post that we made about GPT's limitations. And then I can click on ChatGPT, and this gives me an ability to search for any articles that have referenced ChatGPT in the past, which I think is probably all of them. Suffice it to say, that's a really cool power of Obsidian, is this ability to like link your notes, search through your notes, be able to understand sort of like what's in your notes. So there's some just like nice usability pieces of this. Rome Research was one that did this before. There's a lot of really cool tools that kind of do this thing. And now Notes is actually getting this sort of functionality too. Everyone's kind of catching up to the idea that like, all right, this is the way that like people want to use note-taking applications. So that's great. But now there's nothing like really AI about this. So the first tool that we're going to talk about is Smart Connections. And to enable Smart Connections, we're actually going to go into our settings. We're going to turn on community plugins, which I guess we have to turn on and reload at some point, but let's go ahead and open this up. We're gonna go search for Smart Connections and install that. And we're gonna enable that. And we're gonna be needing to set this up. So what we're gonna go down here and do is we've got a couple different embedding models. And what this is going to do is it's going to set up our Smart Connections to be able to use all of our notes as a RAG system. The ability to do retrieval augmented generation based on our own notes. So I'm going to use Gina as a local model, and I'm going to set that up for both of these. We have not yet created this, so we're going to run embeddings on the 34 notes that we know exist. This can take a little bit of processing power, so we're going to take a minute here. Nice. So now that we've got these embedding models set up, I'll enter my OpenAI key here, set my model to GPT limited access, and then we'll go from there. So now we've got this sort of section set up here, you get these two new tabs over on the side once you have Smart Connection set up. So you have the Smart Connection files, and what that's going to do is it's going to try and find what are the most similar files to the file I have open. So you can see here, and let's say we're talking about like AI for your second brain, which I also had talked about Obsidian in this article too. This kind of goes through and it talks about a bunch of the different things. And over here on the side, you can see, okay, these are actually the notes that are most similar to the note that I have open here, right? So this is like one, even robots take notes. Yeah, it's about note-taking, second brain, note-taking. Those are pretty similar. And this, of course, is just like embedding similarity, right? So that's part of this, right, is the ability to have that similarity here. The other thing that this gives you is this ability to chat with your notes, right? So let's say, what are my thoughts about using Obsidian with AI tools? Now you're kind of getting the details out of the different notes that I was referencing here, right? So it's going to finish sending me a bunch of different information about what I think about Obsidian. So it's like, okay, basically I asked it, what are my thoughts about Obsidian note-taking and AI tools? And it gave me back a very like detailed set of notes about this. Nice thing is I can copy out this note to the clipboard and kind of keep track of that here. So what we can do, we can make that a quote. Go ahead and do a little bit of formatting here. I can also do a couple other things. So I actually can also take the context that was used for this. And so these are all the different like chunks of context that were used from my other notes that were related to this. And the other thing I can do is I can click this I here, was it was able to give me a code block that now has all of the different similarities between my notes, as well as the actual reference details within these notes. And it's able to give me all of that detail and then also show me what it came up with based on all those notes. And this is all like using local models to do the embeddings. It's using ChatGPT to do sort of the chat piece over here. And then it's just using Obsidian for the data and the RAG database here. So we've got links, we've got smart connections. So next is another plugin called Text Generator. So we're going to go back to our community plugins. We're going to go ahead and browse for that one. We're going to install this guy. And so this is more like a command-driven approach to generating text, right? So we're going to enable that. Going to go to the options here. You can use a lot of different providers here too, which is really awesome. Smart Connections is actually like really kind of tied very closely with ChatGPT and the way GPTs sort of work. They have their own GPT that you can kind of pay into. But this one is actually very like much more open by comparison. So I'm just going to set it up right now with just GPT-4, but you can set it up with a lot of other models as well. I'm using the API, of course. Cool. So I've got a key added there. And then there's like a million settings for what you can do with this. But, you know, at its base, I mean, the one cool thing that you can do is like explain what the text generator does. And then we can do generate, text generator, generate text. And it's going to spend a little bit of time to spin this up. And you can immediately see what it's doing here. Once installed, the plugin allows users to generate paragraphs of text. Yep, this has all the right context somehow for this. So that's pretty much what that does. The other thing I really like to do is when you configure it. So I often go in here and I actually turn this on to enable the text to be generated in a block quote. So if we generate that again, and we can also do that. We can either use a command palette, which I like to use, or you can actually just click this generate text button over on the side here. But the nice thing that this does now is it actually puts it into a chat block. So it's kind of obvious like what got generated and like how, and that this was sort of like generated with AI. So if you're generating stuff in your notes with AI, I think oftentimes it's better to like separate it from the stuff that you actually write, just so it's sort of obvious to you in retrospect, like where this came from, where these ideas started. So the last tool, and I mean, honestly, one of my favorite tools on this list is really Excal Draw. We're gonna go ahead and get that installed too. So going back to our community plugins, we're gonna go into browse. It's like the first most popular one on the list. We're gonna run through and install that. Gonna enable it. And then what you can do to enable some of the AI functionality in here is there's actually this AI settings section in here where you can specify sort of like which models you wanna use and how you're kind of doing different things in here. So I'm just gonna use that as my AI model and we'll go through from there. So what you can do then is you can do, I like to do Excal Draw. I can embed something in the current document like that. And you can see this is a reference to the Excal Draw. This is the same as like how you'd render an image or something like that. So now I've got my new Excal Draw here. And say we're going to be building like an app or something like that. So I'm going to do a quick mock-up of like an app that might be developed. All right, cool. So we got some like kind of very basic app kind of going in here. All right, so what we're going to have to do in here is go into this. We're going to go Excal AI. Go down here. We're going to install this script. And now when we highlight this text and we click this button, we are going to generate code based on this prompt here. If I get my head out of the way, okay, we can click the run button at the bottom. And so what this is gonna do is now we are going to use this as a wireframe to generate ourselves a website effectively based on this rough wireframe. So cool, all right, we've got now this basic website built out here, which is pretty awesome. So, you know, it's not quite what we were looking for here, but I didn't give it a lot to go off of. Inside of this guy, I could do like logo or something. So maybe this was V1. So we run this guy, run the code again against that. Let's see what V2 looks like. There we go. Okay, cool. Now we're getting some like interesting styles and different things going on. You can tell it actually just came up with some names rather than the names that I had. And so, yeah, you can kind of see like it's like mocking out something based on sort of like what I put here. And if we resize it, you can see that it's actually like kind of like the app that I was like actually aiming to look for. So you can see pretty cool. You can just kind of mock something up and suddenly you've got like a web page in here too, which is pretty awesome. So I could actually copy out the source code. And then if we wanted to actually see like what the source code is, and you can see here, it does a pretty good job of rendering that. But yeah, and then here's the, this is all HTML. So this is actually the HTML that it generated to render that. It's using Tailwind, and it's got some basic components now that you could pull out. So you could actually say, hey, cool, this is my comment list. It decided these were comments. It's got a bunch of HTML to do this using placeholders. There we go. But yeah, that's a really cool capability of Excal Draw and AI. So I just showed off a bunch of stuff. There's a lot of different things that you can do with Obsidian. There's a lot of different AI tools. There's also ways to configure these tools that I haven't even explored. There's a ton of abilities here. That ability for you to kind of store these notes in a unique way, that's really cool on its own, right? Then we've got smart connections on top of that, which basically allows you to chat with your notes, which is pretty incredible. The ability for you to take all of your notes, put them into a RAG data store, and chat with them. And this isn't like a product. This isn't something that you're buying. It's like, this is a free open source capable tool, right? Then you've also got, of course, like autocomplete, right? So as you're writing something, being able to brainstorm on the go or be able to just generate something really quickly in a unique way using whatever LLM you want. That's a really cool, powerful tool. And now finally, we've got like Excal Draw and the ability for you to like kind of like create a mock-up and get quick code for how do you actually put that on a web page, right? That ability is really amazing as well. And there's more like Excal Draw plugins and things that you can do here as well. It's not just this kind of subset here. But this is why like I love Obsidian and AI. I don't need that much more than this. I've got a couple other plugins that I think are really cool, which I can kind of run you through as well. So one other plugin that I really like is Note Refactor. I use this to kind of just extract snippets of notes. So if I get a note that's getting pretty long, I can quickly just extract that out and put that somewhere else. Language tool is pretty incredible. It effectively is like Grammarly for Obsidian, kind of built in, which is really cool. And it's totally free. You can pay for it, I think, too, but it's mostly free. I use Matter. Matter is kind of like my tool for how I highlight articles and those sorts of things. All of those highlights go into my notes and become also searchable on top of everything else, which I think is like really powerful as well, because it's kind of small details or small parts of notes that I may want to reference later. And so if those are actually in my kind of database, now suddenly I've got not only the things that I've written down, but the things that other people have written down that I found interesting. Data view is awesome. The ability to like just create amazing tables that have different sortings and kind of some SQL-esque commands and things. I find that really cool for being able to do some awesome stuff inside of Obsidian. And then like the final one that I use is like Booksidian, which is the ability to kind of like pull my Goodreads books into Obsidian as well. I just like having the references so I can kind of reference the books in other notes and things. But that's my quick kind of rundown of Obsidian, how I pull in my data, how I use it. I think it's like a really incredibly powerful tool for being able to do a lot of different things. And I think it puts you in this interesting place in relation to AI where you're able to like leverage a lot of the really cool, new, powerful AI techniques and capabilities without pledging yourself to a specific app or platform. If we decide to move away from ChatGPT, OpenAI, and move into like a more Microsoft Gemini space, we could. Anthropic came out with Claude, which is like really awesome these days. I've really enjoyed that. I think the nice thing about Obsidian is that because it's just files, it keeps you flexible, and it really allows you to combine AI and your notes in a really novel and unique way. If you enjoyed this, want to read more, I'd love it if you liked and subscribed to our video here. We also post on Stable Discussion, which is a Substack where we post some of our different ideas, go a little bit more in depth on some of the details and links to a lot of the different things that we source. So feel free to follow us and subscribe over there as well. So thanks so much for tuning in again, and we'll catch you in the next one.